While scientists continue to look for signs of life elsewhere in the universe, Earth remains the only place where we've ever observed living beings. How much longer can Earth support life? Welcome to Untruth. Earth, our home, is estimated to be 4.54 billion years old. While our ancestors lived for over 6 million years, humans as we know them now evolved only 200,000 years ago, and civilization dates back only 6,000 years. We are late to the party, but hopefully, we'll be able to stay until the end. Or not. Even if we survive nuclear and biological conflicts, looming pandemics, as well as long-term climate change consequences, we're all doomed in the end. How long do humans have left? Humans may be to blame for global warming. But behind the scenes, a far slower and more deadly warming process is taking place. Over time, the sun becomes brighter and hotter. As a result, more water from the Earth's surface evaporates into the atmosphere, trapping more heat from the globe. In about 4 billion years, the sun will be 40% brighter. The ice caps will melt forever. The oceans will boil. And all the water vapor in the atmosphere will escape into space. After 9.5 billion years of peacefully burning hydrogen into helium, the sun's core will be devoid of hydrogen. In a star like our sun, all of the gases are drawn toward the center by gravity. If there's enough hydrogen to burn, the outward pressure of radiation will be sufficient to counteract the gravitational force. However, when the sun's core runs out of fuel and can no longer sustain nuclear reactions, the core contracts due to its own gravity. This contraction pushes more hydrogen into a zone with a high enough temperature and pressure to restart fusion in a shell around the helium core. The helium core continues to constrict and heat up, resulting in a faster rate of energy generation in the hydrogen shell. This causes the star to expand massively and brighten, transforming it into a red giant. Our star will expand beyond our imagination, engulfing the inner planets. Mercury and Venus will be consumed by the sun's outer layer as it expands. Earth will be affected as well. Scientists are still discussing whether our planet will be swallowed up by the red giant sun or will orbit dangerously close to it. If it does, Earth would be transformed into a harsh, arid planet, similar to the process that turned Venus into the hellish hothouse it is today. In either scenario, life on Earth will come to an end. There's a 1 in 100,000 chance that as a result of all this expansion, the sun will shed enough mass to lose its gravitational grip on our planet. Then we'll be lost in space, a lonely planet floating aimlessly in the cold, endless night. In reality, life on Earth will most likely be extinguished long before the sun becomes a red giant. Over the eons, our star has gotten warmer, and in a few hundred million years, it'll be hot enough to evaporate the oceans. So, our swollen, red giant sun may not have much left to destroy. the other hand, other planets could benefit from our changing sun. The habitable zone extends outward as the sun gets older and brighter. This means the formerly frozen worlds will melt and liquid water will be present beyond the orbit of Pluto. Because our sun remains a red giant for almost a billion years, life could emerge on far-orbiting planets and moons that would eventually receive some warmth. Without a doubt, the Earth's future is bleak, and we're definitely on our way to extinction as a species. Will we care by then, though? After only a few thousand years of civilization, we have the technology to create bases on the Moon and Mars. So, after billions of years, we'll likely have populated our whole solar system, as well as maybe other planetary systems in the Milky Way galaxy. What would it be like to live on a planet other than our own? You may find your answer in another Untruth.